Hello, and welcome back to Dusty Dungeon, another installment of Taco's Tactics Corner Power Hour Flower Power Hour Hour. That is hopefully less than an actual hour. So let's get right into this. We've got some roaches, serpents, they're in cages that I guess you open with this orb, sure. Then there's that Wraithwing, and that's on a scroll. And that closes the cages again, okay. So where are we gonna kill those serpents? We could lure roaches into the cages. Or we could kill them over here. Okay. Well, might as well just lure some roaches in first. That'll be a little bit easier. Alright, so this might be a little bit harder to deal with because now we're gonna be surrounded, but that's okay. I'll just deal with the other serpents as they come. I guess I'll just do the rest of this room on autopilot, essentially. But in rooms like this, you definitely want to avoid being surrounded. Now, you could take cover down here, but I definitely don't want roaches to get, like, over here, and surround me like that. That would not be... Yeah, like, that can happen pretty much automatically like that. So I'm going to back up a bit. Let's see. That serpent's gonna want to come down here, but maybe I can get it to go up like that. There we go. Take advantage of vertical preference. Send it up that way, and it won't bother me for that. There we go. That should buy me enough time to thin this out and actually get somewhere. Even though the number of roaches is a little large, it's not a big problem. Sure, that'll do. Getting a little crowded here, so I guess I'll back up and pretend that I wasn't quite that aggressive. And we'll do that. Oh, well, hey, look at that. Well, we'll be back there later. Much later, I assure you. Or maybe not that much later. Definitely not right now. You'll see why. Alright, let's see what that piece of paper has to say for us. That's not too much harder than what I did. I mean, you start with more serpents on the field, but, again, that's pretty much what I did. Alright, it looks like this is actually the last room on the level. Yeah, there's nowhere else to go from here, so let's get right into it. So what have we got? We've got that. That's gonna die eventually. And we can't hit that orb until it does. So in the meantime, there's a brain that's gonna be sending these roaches after us. Okay. But we also want to kill these eventually at some point, and then go in here, get that, but then... Yeah, so lots of things we could do. We don't necessarily have to do this last. This is the thing we do last. So there's a lot to do. So these will just stay in place. This is fine. I don't have to mess with this. So really, it's just a question of how are we going to deal with this. Because I think if we go in here without anything, like, we're just going to die, aren't we? Like, this is the only brain in the room, so maybe we might be able to loop back around, but then how do we kill the snake? Like, we can't really dodge around the goblin. I don't want to push him through this wiggly passageway, so we probably just want to bring something in here with us, like a Wraithwing, maybe? Or a Roach Queen. Roach Queen would work, too. So, yeah, one of those. Put them in here. And we should be good to go? Alright. So then, is there any real reason to mess with any of this? There's no reason to mess with this yet, but this is going to be... I don't know. Which one is going to be more annoying? Well, I can't really do anything with this yet, so let's just actually get started. Might as well get some free cuts in now while we don't actually have the like that first cycle of roaches. From this point forward, everything is going to be, like, in a cycle, but, like, this is the, like, least interrupted period we've got. So I'm just going to go ahead and kill all these roach queens. I don't think I'm going to want to use them. I'm just going to use one of these Wraith Wings instead. So we'll have to deal with these, but they're all in a line. That's the nice thing about this funnel, is that'll cause the roaches to automatically sort themselves in a movement order. So that's good for us. You know, there might be some one-tile gaps. It won't be so bad. Okay. So how are we going to deal with this, then? We don't necessarily need to drop any of these trapdoors in specific, but in order to get this down here, we're going to need this one's help. So let's just see what we can do. Yeah, the tricky part is that this Wraith is also going to be moving in a braid fashion, so it's going to be a bit harder to manipulate than usual. Not too bad, but in combination with the other one, it's going to be a little annoying. Let's see. It's not so bad if it goes on these arrows, so that's okay. I just need to force it southeast. And this force arrow maze isn't too bad. Let's just get him on that side. Then they'll be easier to... a little bit easier to manipulate. Right there. How's that? That's a bit better. Way. It's easier said than done because of this other Wraith Wing being all up in my business. Okay, that's a bit better. Almost. You go down there. Yeah, that's more like one. But they have to be at like a proper angle. I mean, really, I guess I can't really put the Wraith Wing over here because it's brain. So, really. So I could just get a Roach Queen in here and deal with this part first, just so that this part is easier. I mean, that's... So basically, it's do I want to be annoyed over here with something that's slightly harder, or do I want to be annoyed over here with something that's slightly harder? I guess I'll take this one. I mean, this one's not so bad. I could just work out a good way of actually getting this all done. Yeah, that's another thing I can do, is use my sword to kind of try and mess with this one's movement, but it's not necessarily going to be that easy. Alright, yeah, this is going to be a little bit too annoying to deal with. I have to do that several times over, and then it kind of wouldn't be that bad afterwards, but it's just too awkward. Like, there's a Wraith Wing over there. Like, I could probably have put it over here and then used brain... like, the way it calculates brain distance to keep this one going south on this side of the wall, and then use that as, like, absolute distance separation from this one, but that might lead to surrounding. It's just too much bother. It'll be easier to work with if they're on brain, I think. So I'm going to restart. That's why I restarted. Kind of, you know, I need to explain these things. Alright, so... we're going to deal with those roaches, and we're going to try and get the Wraith Queen all the way out. Now, that might actually not be so easy, particularly because I'm getting an overrun by roaches, so maybe we won't use that. The way the Wraith Queens work, I probably haven't actually mentioned this because it hasn't really been relevant so far. Let me go back so it's a little bit easier to show. Alright, so the way Brain Queens work is, this is explained a lot better in Advanced Concepts, the Advanced Brain Movement Annex, but essentially, they will try and move the opposite of a brain roach. But, the reason that they don't, they'll never move orthogonally, unless they're, like, unbrained for some reason, like this one that's on Force Arrows to the west. That one's unbrained, I believe. But anyone that's brained will always try and make a diagonal. And the way they figure that out is, if they're trying to move in a vertical direction away from you, then they will move towards the center column of the group. So this one wants to go south, but instead it's actually going southeast towards the center column. Now, similarly, this one that's right here, is trying to go horizontal. It wanted to go horizontally to the west, but it's being adjusted towards the center row of the group. So it wants to go diagonally down left. There's probably another room that I could show that's a bit easier to show this off in. Let's see. Yeah, wow, this is actually kind of a headache as well. Okay. I thought this would make my life easier, but I guess it won't. Alright, never mind. I'm not gonna mess with that at all then. I mean, you have to be willing to try multiple approaches, but that one just seems like even worse than the other one, so I'm not even going to bother. Especially since if I did, it would involve more unlimited undo, and that might compromise the intellectual purity. I mean, that's probably not really the actual phrase I would use, but, you know, this was designed to be played without undo. So, there has to be, like, a method that's not fundamentally a pain in the butt, is I guess what I'm trying to say. And that is my intellectual elucidation on the map. I have to actually hit that order. Alright, now as I was saying, I can't just kill this Wraithwing because at the very end I need a Wraithwing to be attracted to me here to actually kill it. Is that right? Yeah, that's right. However, this is a toggle war, so there's no particular reason I have to actually let it out. So, maybe I won't. I mean, there are safe places to stash this where I can just get it back, so... Yeah, now we should be far enough away that, yeah, this one up here won't matter. There we go. Gotta take appraisal of all of your resources. In this case, you know, it's the orb that lets me not be bothered by that Wraithwing all the way up there. A very useful orb, I'm sure you'll agree. Alright, so now I can stash this up there in that corner, it won't bother me. Now I can go all the way back up here and get the other one. Alright, see, we're getting into more complicated territory, just so you see. Right, so now I only have to do this part once, where I get this to run away and then come back to me. Need to be a little bit more careful here. There we go. Okay, so now that's done, and now, let's not forget, this Wraithwing's job is not yet done. But fortunately, the brain will lead the Wraithwing right to me. Let's see, we're gonna need to get it on this side of the snow. So I guess I'll lure it in here like that, and then... yeah, I guess that one. I'm gonna have to need to get to my west somehow, so that's gonna be a little bit tougher. That should do it. Yeah, because now I should be able to make it go to the west. That. And then send it upwards and inwards. Yeah, like that. There we go. Okay, so now we have a Wraithwing in here with us. That I can just make go upwards like that. Except now we have a goblin on us. Okay. Well, there's a new problem. Alright, how are we going to get not eaten by this goblin? I don't know. Like that, I guess. Okay, there we go. That takes care of the snake. We'll go in here and, once again, looks like the brain has left a message for us. Let us see. Ah, another Bavada's dungeon puzzle. This one is, yeah, I guess I can kind of see that. This was, similar to some of the snake rooms in level 4, but, this eastern section, I don't know. Like, the overall whole is different, but, each of the individual parts are lovingly borrowed, I guess. Anyway, so here comes the, fun part. Now I have to deal with all this when it's unbrained. And, we have a, you know, ginormous number of, rages spawning here. Which looks like it's actually going to be nearly 15. But we should be able to break in here eventually. Alright, maybe just run for it now. No, that's not going to be quite good enough, or is it? Like, how many... No, actually, it's not quite. Each one of these isn't spawning 3. This one is spawning 2. So actually, it's 14. So we will be able to get through here eventually. If we were like 15 or 16, I probably would be able to, but if I can just keep up the rate, I should be able to break in here eventually. If I can just get a free move somewhere. Is that going to be enough? No, not quite. Almost, but not this time. Ideally, I'd like to be able to just wait in here and then kill, like, one per turn, but that's not really happening. So I just want to avoid wasting too much time. So what else can I do in this situation? Like, that's the best I've gotten so far, like, killing, like, three in a row as I get out there. But the movement order does not support that. Go upwards? No. So I think I just want to adjust the movement order so that's a bit easier to kill these on the way in. Like, is there anything else I could put in here? No, I can't put a snake in here. I could put a Wraithwing in here. I don't know how much help that would be. Could be some help, maybe. Like, how much would it be? Like, I could, like, block one of these roaches from spawning, maybe? I don't know, I guess it's worth a try. Let's back up. If I were smart, I would have hit the checkpoint down here, but, you know, maybe I didn't for whatever reason. So let's just make sure I don't have to redo too much here. By, you know, using Beethor's time powers that he has been developing throughout the course of these games. In just a second. Just a minute. Just an hour. Okay, there we go. When did we kill that Wraithwing? Probably, like, right after we killed the snake, I think. Look, I don't know why Beethor's sword is spitting out roaches any more than you do, but, that's just how it goes. Okay. Get back here. Yeah, there we go. So here's when we killed the Wraithwing, and, you know, we might not want to kill the Wraithwing. Actually, that's a good question. How are we going to get it in here? Well, it's okay. Yeah, we don't have to push it in here. We can pull it out. You can either push or you can pull a Wraithwing, but, you know, if one doesn't work, try the other one. Let's see. How are you going to get it back through here, though? That's not quite so simple. I guess you just don't want to let it ever get this far or something. So, like this, I guess. Oh, that's not, if it gets in here, then that's not good. I don't know, maybe we don't have to actually rescue this Wraithwing. But yeah, there's no way we're gonna get past this part unless we pull it out like this. And then we just don't have enough leverage. We can't step to the east here like we want to. Unless, like, somehow this does anything? No, no, of course not. Alright, well, that was a nice try. I guess we're not gonna make our lives easier quite that way. And as we noted, there was no way to actually get this Wraithwing, so that single one was the only one we could actually use. So back to doing this, I guess. You know, how about that nice underground weather, huh? Alright. Fortunately, we have turbo speed, and hopefully we can actually get some kind of tactical use out of this. Actually, this might be good, because now this old roach is blocking this one, so maybe we can kill a bunch this way. Maybe movement order is better now? Nope. Movement order is definitely not better. Could have been, but it just wasn't. Alright, so what else? That was okay. Maybe if we go down to the south, we can actually make it this time. Like, we're gonna have to be a little bit more more of a different direction. Okay, there we go. Got that movement order problem all settled out. That was a little bit more annoying than it had to be. There might have been some way to have an orb in here that you could hit that made this part easier. But I don't know. That was okay. Could have been a lot worse. So, we're all done, right? Yeah, I mean, we just want to walk all the way, to this the staircase. But, unfortunately, Smite Master can never leave work undone. So, welcome to this room. It's Tar on Trapdoors, so, have fun. So, complicating the matter, of course, is all these monsters that are buried in the tar. The monsters themselves are not that hard to deal with. The trouble is just how they change the shape of the tar. Especially as far as making cuttable shapes goes. So I think the way I'm going to deal with this is I'm going to skip this one tar on the way out and just leave it alive. So that way I can always have growing tar when I get all the way out here, and then when I start making it all the way back through here, I'll still have growing tar because I won't have killed all the tar birds yet. So, just sitting here feeling sorry for ourselves isn't going to solve the room, so let's just get right into it. Put it up here. Yeah, I don't want to do that, so that's really the best we're going to be able to do. And make that shape, I guess. Yeah, that seems fair. So yeah, I'm going to sneak along the bottom. So I'll just deal with all this later. I just want to carve a path from the bottom, just not worry about the precise shape yet. Because what'll happen is the tar will just kind of fill itself back in nicely. Or at least it should. Well, let's be a little bit more careful than that. But yeah, that's kind of the insidious thing about the way these monsters are placed is, they're not neat and stuff like this. So we actually probably want something like this. I'll leave that open. I guess we'll just save that for later. And that should be okay. Alright, that looks better. Should be able to deal with that on the way out, that on... Alright, this could be a problem as well. So maybe we want to clean this up beforehand, then. Let's just make sure we've got our approach correct. Alright, so we need to cut that, cut this, and then retreat like that. So we can actually leave that open. And then, like, maybe this is a bit too narrow. Maybe we should just work on cutting all the tar when we go out. I mean, that's more trouble than it's worth, really, but... And maybe we just want to leave this one open because it's a little bit easier to sneak past. That could be true. Yeah, so maybe we just leave, kill this one. And clear out some favorable space. Maybe not that. So we'll wait here then? No, not there. Not like that either. Man, this is pretty hard. I mean, that pretty much just goes without saying, but, sometimes you have to affirm these things. But really, as long as I can find opportunities to cut this stuff, I might as well. Like, this, that's a good one. Yeah, so that's, there's problems, for sure. Alright, let's try that one more time, just to make sure that our approach is correct. Because I know that there is an easy way to do this. At least, like, relatively speaking. So we're gonna do this, and back up. I like this part. You know, those first few moves, they were good. Back. And then we'll drop those to make that a 2x3 kind of outgrowth. That might be a little bit better. There we go. I like the way this is going. Except, well, I'll just drop it. That's all. I'll just like it. There we go. That behind, do that behind, so that. Yeah, nothing wrong here. Well, hold on, something went wrong here. Damn, this room goes wrong very fast, as I'm doing. Because again, it's tar on trappers. It's everybody's favorite. Well, hold on, which of these grows first again? It's the tar. Tar goes first. Well, I guess it's okay if I just leave this here done, right? Because that should... Well, no, it's... No, that's just not good. I can't let that shape, right? So I'm going to have to deal with that particular blob earlier. Like that, I guess? I mean, actually, I guess it's... Yeah, well, do I want to leave this like that? Yeah, I can deal with that. That's fine. That is okay. Alright, so like I said, I'm gonna leave this tar model real quick. Is that okay? I guess that's okay. I'm not gonna worry about that. Okay. But this is what I want. Just like nice, even, like, just three wide shapes like this. These are relatively easy to clean up on trapdoors as long as you have enough space to actually get a nice corner to defend yourself with. But this should be okay. This is gonna be three. Hold on. This might. Is this going to be okay? Yeah, because that's a single cut. That'll be fine. Cut that, and then we'll get an L-shaped one. That'll be okay. We'll be able to deal with that, then drop all these, kill the brain. That'll be fine. I'm also going to hit this to lock the room, just so that, we don't get a tragedy much later on. That'd be pretty bad. And, hold on. Let's make sure this Wraith thing doesn't try anything clever. And we'll just keep going. Okay. I think that was the hard one. I think we're actually past the worst of it. Yeah, believe it or not, I think we're actually in good shape. Now, how do we want to deal with this part? Because that's going to be an awkward shape. I guess we'll let it grow. Yeah, and then we'll cut it like that. Obviously, I'm not going for the high score on this. No, that is definitely not a thing. Okay, this might actually, yeah, that's fine. Because I have, I have this shape. That shape's okay. Yeah, and again, I just want to try and get rid of as many of these monsters as possible to kind of smooth out the tar. Because when it's all bumpy like this, that's when it's the hardest to cut. Is when there's all these extra monsters in there that kind of really shouldn't be. Let's see now. So that, I probably want to kill quite. That should be better. Right, now I'll kill those. Now it's all smooth. This could be... I'm not really liking that shape. I think I kind of pinched it a little bit too much there. But I kind of had to in order to cut that in the first place. Alright. Alright, that looks a little bit better, and I guess we're just going to leave those monsters in there. I guess they were better where they were. Thank you. Let's see, that's obviously going to be no good. Yeah, that's just not going to be any good no matter what way we do that. I can drop another one. Like, well... yeah, I guess it'd have to be shaped like that. And that's pretty awkward. But it's still not that bad, actually. If I could survive this part, then I'd be set, actually. That wouldn't be so bad. But yeah, in like this thread, where it's like even narrower than this part, I'd probably just clear out all the tar. But I think we're still on track. Like, nothing's wrong with this shape. This shape's fine. So I just need to handle this northeast corner. But yeah, this is pretty much as hard as it gets when it comes to tar cutting. Yeah, we'll let that grow back. Yeah, there we go. That's probably the saner way of handling this. Let's see, is that okay? Well, I guess that's okay. Alright. Except that, actually. Will that be okay? Yeah, that should be okay. Yeah, that'll be fine. Need to cut that again. Alright, sorry for this sparse commentary, but you can basically see what's happening here. It's very, very careful tar tactics here. In fact, I should be able to get away with this. There we go. Alright, so this whole pathway looks fine. We've got this tar mother that'll keep this growing. This should all be fine to deal with, so I'm past that part. Now, it'll actually get easier as we get up into here, I think. At least that's what I think. Because, you know, there's going to be some narrow parts here and here, but this whole area is actually wider, which will actually make it easier to get through, because we'll be able to cut away some of these interior lumps, get, you know, carve all this out, smooth out the tar. And then when it's just tar on trapdoors and it's smoother, it'll be actually easier to get through. You'll see. So we're going to be here a while. This might actually take more than one episode. Or maybe it'll just be an actual special hour-long episode. I don't know. But yeah, I've got no particular reason to deal with this now. I mean, well, I kind of do, though. Like I said, I wanted to clear out these monster pockets, so it's probably just best if I do that ahead of time. As best as I can without squeezing things too much. So I probably want something like that, then. Like, is that okay? That should be okay. As long as I clear enough space for it. This might actually not be okay. Yeah, that actually doesn't look okay. Alright, so I won't deal with that until... just gonna keep going along my strategy. So this part is gonna be a little bit tricky because it's a too wide thing. But how are we gonna get here? Broken walls? Okay. That shouldn't be too bad. So's that. So that won't be too bad. So I'll come back for that later, that's fine. Hold on, that's gonna grow one more time, isn't it? Yeah. So how do we deal with this part, actually? That's a good question. Because ideally, what I would want is for, like, this particular square, like, on east to be dropped. Then it can deal with that okay. Yeah, I can't actually do that from this angle, can I? Like, the best angle to actually deal with this from would be, like, coming from the north. Yeah, so actually what I want to do is just leave that there. If possible. So I need to take more of a zigzaggy approach to this. So I'll need to let that grow. I'm going to leave this here. I can still get it. Yeah, I can still get it if I come in here. So leave that like that. I need to cut that, leave this open. And we'll successfully make a crossover like this. Actually, I didn't realize I could cut that, so that's okay. Alright, so later on, we will come from over here, go down through here, cut this, get rid of all this, and then come back up through here and then clean that up. Let's drop all these. I drop that, and I'll also get rid of this narrow bit here. There. So now this place is cleared out. That's Tar Baby's not a problem. And we'll creep up through here, and then come down through here. And this shouldn't be so bad. Still plenty of room here. This is all fine, nothing's changed over here, so yeah, just gotta deal with this section. So that's it, you just gotta take these rooms nice and slow. Deal with them one section at a time. And, you know, not mess things up like that. But yeah, you just need to, you know, sometimes you just wanna let it grow into a better shape. Oh, well, that's just awkward. That's better. Just get them out of there and let it grow like that. Okay. Then hopefully I can kill these. Yeah, that kind of got out of hand. Okay. Let's maybe not do that. Also, at some point, I'm going to need to break that to let the serpent out. So, maybe, yeah, let's just cross over that. That might be a bit better. Yeah, just like that. Serpent will eventually kill itself somehow. And then... yeah, I probably need to deal with that now. And by now, I mean as soon as I deal with that goblin. There we go. That's a better shape. Well, not like that. Be a little bit more careful. Yeah, like, that's the correct option. I should be able to deal with this tar and then get back out. I should be able to. If I do this... okay. There we go. Not so bad. It looks scary, but it's scarier than it is. It looks scarier than it actually is. That's what I'm trying to say. I mean, I realize it's kind of, you know... it's kind of hard to commentate over stuff like this, but the very, you know, it's okay. Could be worse. Well, that's not really what I wanted to happen. Alright, just gonna steadily chip away at it, and we're nearly there. Gonna get there one of these days. Okay. As long as you just keep your tactics in mind, it's not so bad. Let's see. Let it roll like that, and then cut it. Oh, that was a regular roach, not a roach queen. And here. And here. Okay. We made it all the way to the back. Now we just have to wait our way forward. So far, it looks everything looks fine. My, nice and masterful setup plan here. It's gonna be a little bit awkward cleaning this up, but that shouldn't be so bad. Tell you what, yeah, because of the way this is shaped, I can let it grow like this, then I can cut it, and then I can escape it with here. There we go. That takes care of this whole section. Step on another checkpoint. Sure, yeah, just do that. Take advantage of all this solid ground we've got. So we can take advantage of this wonderful open passageway with no tar corner that I set up earlier. Good for me. And yeah, this part should be the easy part, and this part is going to be a little bit tougher, but shouldn't be that bad. And even when this isn't growing, I should be able to take care of this. So it's just a matter of time. It's got to go through the motions, I'm afraid. I mean, this is, this is going to be really boring. But, so it goes. Sometimes these rooms are just boring. I mean, seriously, what do you expect? Hold on. Let's do that. Then we'll deal with... hold on. Now we're making some progress. Okay, well, we should be able to clean that up. That shouldn't be so bad. Here's another wrinkle. Now this Wraithman's gotten back out. Well, we should be able to kill it with this one's help, and then maybe kill this one before it escapes. Really did not really see that ahead of time, but should be okay. Yeah, I'm gonna need to cross over this one. Kind of like this. Yeah, that should be good. Except it's not. It's close. Nearly had that. There we go. That'll fix it. Now, of course, if I were doing this without unlimited undo, I'd be doing this a lot slower, even. But I'd also be very carefully paying attention to what kind of tar shapes I was making. Because, again, that's really the prerequisite for actually being able to solve this room, is knowing your tar shapes by heart. You know, what's going to be easy to deal with and what is not. At least when it's on trapdoors, at least. I think we're basically... I didn't forget anything up here. No. Everything up here is clear. Good. That grow like that and retreat there. And that will make a complete shape. Alright, so far so good. And yeah, good shapes all around. Little bit. How are we gonna deal with this? Probably let it grow again. Yeah, how? So it started like that. Maybe I want to let it grow like this then? Yeah, that looks better. So I'm gonna let it grow like that. I can cut that easily. Cut that easily, and now it looks like this, and that's easy. Thank you. Yeah, just, I'm just gonna let that grow twice. I'm in no hurry. There. And again, see how much easier this is to all deal with when I have the tar mother here growing this all out for me. If this was all static tar, then I'd have to worry about, well, is it a cuttable shape? But because I still have the tar mother that's alive, I don't have to worry about that as long as I can just let it grow into a shape that is cuttable. So that just makes my life, going back this way a lot easier. Even if I have to deal with the tar expanding, at least I'll know that I'll probably be able to get through it. So like that. Like that. And then that one. Okay. Alright, that took a while, but thankfully I did not have to really restart it all that much. I think we should be there now, right? Okay, so that is how you do this one. With few problems. Let's see, let's get a move count. Over 2,000 moves, but there's obviously ways to do this faster, but if you were looking for just a good movie to watch, that's over 10 minutes long, you can download a faster demo of this one. Alright, so let us get to the third level, and then I guess I'll call it for this episode, because that's quite enough work for, one viewing session. But, we can take this nice little reminiscent stroll through all these rooms that we solved on the east side. That's always good. You can just admire your handiwork. Just, a nice breath of fresh air with, no seep or puffs to ruin it. There's still spikes around, but, those are natural dungeon features. There's not much they can really do about that. Now that it's safe for the maintenance workers to replace the trapdoors in peace, we can actually move on to where further challenges will await us. And here we are. We can even still make it to the stairs. Excellent. Alright, so next time, third level, which will probably be even harder. Good times.